Lancer has been set up to investigate organised crime in King's Cross. Now, since February, there's been 14 kneecappings, all drug-related. And now, 50-plus shots fired into a nightclub door in full view and range of 30 witnesses.
Go, 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 go!
So I think you all agree. Organised crime in the Cross has reached Olympian heights.
The wait is over. Too pretty and too small to be the toughest. But you're smart enough to be the smartest. The time has finally come.
The big bloody cake on hand, there is a very good dollar to be made every week.
The next true story begins now with a massive two-hour premiere.
Are you aware that escorting involves nudity? What's the pay like?
Have you forgotten what it's like out in the real world?
Real world's changing, Jim.
I need what you've got on the police force.
For the last 40 years, the whole of New South Wales has been for sale. Do you really want to go back there?
Nine's Underbelly starts now.
Sits, putting on the Ritz. Different types who wear a day coat, pants with stripes and cutaway coat, perfect fit. Putting on the Ritz.
Once upon a time, there was a land of neon rainbows called King's Cross, where fantasies could be bought and nightmares walk the streets. It was a Neverland. A land on another planet. A land where a western suburb schoolboy called John Ibrahim came to seek his fortune.
Free period.
What happened to your hand? What happened? What happened?
Nothing happened.
Show me your hand. Show me your hand.
There we go. Huh. What? Piss off.
Show me your hand.
There's nothing.
Show me your hand. What happened?
I think you're fucking cool, don't you, Ibrahim? Dirty fucking lamp.
So that's why you got kicked out?
No, I just walked out.
It's him that should be expelled for racial vilification, man.
Vilification.
Yeah,
listen,
whatever.
What about your HSC?
I'm done with school.
What? Man, you're a dude, man. You know what plans we've all got for you?
Yeah, I got plans of my own.
What? Man, not this stuff again.
Oh, come on, I've been working doors for ages, eh?
Well, how long have you been at Images for, John?
18 months.
Cut a bit of time on the...
Hey, Paris, not the Cross, okay?
No, it's not.
Mm.
You can't stop me working here, though.
Yes, I can.
Oh, come on. I can help you out, mate.
Mate, you can't even do what you're told. You're a short ass. You're going to get in my way. Go home. Go home. Go. Far out, man. Just can't do what he's told.
See you, Johnny.
Yeah, Johnny.
Hammer, real name Harry Hammoud, and the other boys John Ibrahim looked up to all came from the same streets out west. Their families had emigrated from the same part of Lebanon. They grew up together, went to school together. Briefly. They were like brothers, a band of up-for-anything brothers. And Hammer's particular skills, taekwondo, hot-headedness, no regard for personal safety, earned him a reputation for never losing a fight. And a reputation for reckless violence comes in handy when you're collecting protection money. Which is kind of like insurance cover against acts of reckless violence. Was the vice capital of Sydney. No, make that Australia. A 1 mile stretch of strip clubs, brothels, nightclubs, discos, restaurants, coffee shops, and heartbreaking sob stories. Whatever your poison, whatever your perversion, it was for sale on the Golden Mile. And people flooded there every night with pockets full of cash. Moths to a neon flame. It was a license to print money for those who controlled King's Cross. So who were the Kings of the Cross? The hard old men of Sydney's underworld, George Freeman and Lenny McPherson.
What's your name?
Morrison.
First name?
Van.
Well, you look about as Irish as I do.
Arrest the little prick officer and give him a slap over the head. Save me the trouble.
I am more scared of him than you.
You two know each other, do you?
Oh, a smart copper on our hands.
Yeah.
We really need to be careful now.
Let's get out of here, huh? Huh? Hey, I thought I told you to go home.
Trains were all full.
Collecting money for George and Lenny wasn't the only use Hammer put his skills to. He freelanced his muscle for most of the clubs and brothels, and a message on his pager that said Pink Flamingo, no ties, meant that matters had got past the canapé stage.
Hey, what's going on? Where are you off to?
Well, Pink Flamingo.
You need a hand?
No, I'll page you.
Sure.
Okay. Hey, yes. Stay there.
Oh, come on, let me come
stay
with
there.
You.
Stay there.
Stay here with us, mate.
Come on.
Stay back here with us, mate.
The Golden Mile was a law unto itself. But its denizens understood very well the need for order. When order breaks down, violence breaks out, punters get scared off, and the money dries up. And that cannot be tolerated. Bouncers, doormen, enforcers like Hammer, they all shared this love of order. So when a mob of drunken out-of-towners overpower local security staff, peace has to be restored, and quickly. And that's what this is, by the way. A peacekeeping exercise.
What the fuck do you think you're doing?
I just saved your hairy Lebanese ass, mate.
Like fuck you did.
Oi, what's going on here?
Nothing.
Had a report of a brawl.
Yeah, you're fucking a bit late.
I've done your job for you.
Is everything all right? You guys all right in here?
Yeah. All right, boys?
Yeah. What about you, sir? Are you okay?
Yeah, I'm fine.
King's Cross 51 of EKG. Everything's pretty fuck quiet off. On the street here.
Get out of here. Fuck
check
off.
Check out inside.
Get out. Now, you got to admit, that was a pretty good kick.
Fucking over-reese, mate. Your balance was all wrong.
Oh, shit. Man. I'm type 1 dealer, mate. First you must learn to stand, then you must learn to fly.
Yeah, Ross wants me over at Pussycat. Suppose might as well come.
Oh, you need my short ass down, do you?
Oh, I need a mascot.
John Abraham wasn't the only one attracted to the pots of gold on the Golden Mile.
All right, don't miss a bus.
Good luck at your job, Dad.
Thanks, sweetheart. Bye-bye.
Bank card payments due.
Mm-hmm. I'll see her.
Greedy coppers could see the appeal of working in a place where the language was money. But Detective Sergeant Trevor Haken, a transfer to King's Cross, was like an express train to the promised land.
It's what I call the general revenue shelf. Yeah, it's for general use. Anyone in the office can eat all of that. This shelf down here, though, individual use only. Now, the label system really helps out there, otherwise the whole
the French fairy finished boring your balls off yet?
It's a system joke.
Come here. Okay, this is Grunter.
G'day, mate.
Sure. And this is Parrot.
G'day. Yeah.
They're working on those bashings of McClay Street, aren't you, gentlemen?
Yep, we're out. Let's go.
And Scully's supposed to be up to his perspiring pits in car rebirthing, but I don't know what the fuck he's doing.
I've got a lot on my plate right now, why is it that all the work here comes to me? Sorry, Jimmy.
Jim?
I'll call you back, mate.
So what do you want me on?
Oh, well, take your pick. What have we got here? Attempt murder? Assault with a deadly weapon? Drug deals, soliciting, more drug deals. I tell you, average punter on a Saturday afternoon mowing his lawn. Ain't got a clue what goes on here.
Well, that has its advantages.
What do you reckon, Jim? You two go back a ways. What do you reckon Sergeant Haken's good for?
I'm tempted to say nothing.
Any joking, Trev?
Look, mate, there's a joke on here. There's a big bloody joke on, and there's a very good dollar to be made every week. Oh, it's tea time, Jim, mate. Why don't you take Trev out and get us some victuals? Oh, don't forget your lunch, mate.
He's a drug dealer. He's another.
Who's the big blana in the drug trade up here?
There isn't one, really. Three or four blokes, got a few drug dealers each. Though, that piece of work over there has got delusions of grandeur. Bill Bayer. He owns a gambling joint on Bayswater Road. See the small guy?
Mm-hmm.
He's a fist. They call him Captain Jack.
Lunchbox. Evening.
How you doing, boys?
This is Sergeant Haken.
Nice to meet you, Sergeant Haken. You want me to? I've had all the lonesome I can stand.
The playmates in the magazines are only ink and paper dreams. I'll go home with you. Just take my mate, you should see the pavers that I'm putting around the patio. Real flash.
Yeah, that reminds me. Scales, have you bought that new rod yet?
Nothing wrong with the old one, sure.
Oh, that'll be the one Moses used when he was an ipper?
Favourite rod.
Made an arrest on that bashing.
Confession?
Signed it in the can.
Well, I think that deserves a little bit of overtime there.
Thanks, mate.
You don't mind holding the fort, do you, Scouts? You can do a fridge order, mate.
King's Cross detectives were headed up by the legendary Chuck Fowler. A hard man from the old school who was tougher than all the doormen, bouncers and enforcers rolled into one. Trevor Haken had just found his role model.
New recruit.
I found him on the street. He followed me home.
John Abraham. Nice to meet you, Mr. McPherson. How you going? Pleased to meet you, Mr. Freeman.
You can bring the car around when you're ready.
Hey, you know those new $10 notes have got more anti-counterfeiting devices than any other money in the world? Shadow images, microprinting, even fluorescent ink. It's good to know your own's the real thing, eh?
What the fuck was that all about?
It's called networking, mate.
It's called being a zip, more like it.
Oh, yeah, you're a zip.
Oi, they're expecting you at the door of the tunnel.
From the burbs, are we?
Hey, there's no law against checking out the cross.
So you work here now, Johnny?
Yeah, I work here.
So what are you, like a bouncer?
No, I'm just perusing my future investments.
What?
Streets here are paved with gold, love.
Oh, is that right? So you heard how the school social's coming up? Kind of a shame you won't be there.
Hey, who says I won't?
You can't go. You got expelled, remember?
Said you wouldn't do this anymore.
Come on, give me a break. It was my welcome drinks.
Cheers. Here's to a top evening with the wives tonight.
In King's Cross, morality was negotiable. One man's sin was another man's salvation. The crooks liked to think that they had a code of honour, while the dirty cops prayed that their good deeds outweighed the kickbacks, payoffs and bribes that paid for the kids' teeth and their wife's fancy shoes. Every man has his line in the sand. The King's Cross detectives drew theirs perilously close to the water's edge.
Babysitter's at 11.
Come on, the boys want to show us a good time.
See ya. Well, hey, darling. Hey, buddy. How are you?
So, who's your favourite arrest, Jim? Druggies or hookers?
As long as the streets are nice and clean and safe and the average punt is happy, I'm a happy copper. So how's kids, mate? I mean, they must be getting bigger, much bigger.
Don't buy dildos, sexy. I'll provide the real thing for free.
What'd you say to my wife?
She's your wife.
Fuck me, you pay her to get hitched to you?
You want to wash your manners, buddy?
Nothing wrong with my fucking manners. Yeah.
Trevor, just leave it.
Listen, mate, you even look at her again, I'll rip your fucking nuts off.
I'm shitting myself, Romeo. We all are.
Sergeant, very control.
lucky day, mate.
Take these shitbags back to the station office. We'll sort it out there.
Open the van, piss off.
Hoody hoody!
Constable Webb!
Ladies first.
Out you come!
Those guys, they'd already started fighting playbirds. Maybe they had it coming. You don't think they did?
No, actually.
Then why didn't you say something?
It's wrong time, wrong place. Any complaint you or I make will go nowhere.
Then things will never change, will they? Stick our bloody heads in the sand.
It's not about sticking our heads in the sand, Deb. It's about making sure they don't get shot off.
Jimbo.
Look at this.
Thanks for coming up.
No worries, mate. Looking very spiffy there.
Yeah, here at command dinner. Don't have to wear it too often. Thank Christ.
So, mate, bush telegraph's flickering.
Mm-hmm.
You King's Cross boys had a busy night.
Just in a fray, mate. 10 piss clams out on a bucks night.
Give you any trouble?
No.
Word is, they ended up looking like Jeff Fenwick's sparring partner.
Well, they resisted arrest, didn't they?
You used only necessary force?
Of course.
I mean, nothing. Commissioner Avery wouldn't think it was 100% kosher.
You know, Dan, you and your beloved leaders have been sitting behind desks for too long. Have you forgotten what it's like out in the real world?
Real world's changing, Jim.
We're just trying to do our job.
Mate, just doing your job. You know, journos, mate, print King's Cross police brutality.
Hey, and the job gets harder for all of us, mate.
What would those bloody journos know, Dan? I'd like to see them spend a day, half a day out there on the cross, dealing with the shit that we've got to deal with. I mean, come on. I mean, those scumbags were marching up and down Darlow Road all night, causing trouble. They insulted Trev's wife, then they attacked us. They kicked Sean Sinclair's head so hard, he's got 6 stitches. Now, any sort of injuries that they have happened during the brawl or in the process of arrest.
That's what your incident reports will say.
That's what happened.
So what's Mel Mel done, mate?
Nothing.
So why are we going there? To kick his head in?
Well, who says we're kicking anyone's head in, huh? We're just going there for a drink.
Ronnie. Yeah. No.
All right, let's go.
Some druggies took my board. I can't impart the word of the Lord if I don't have a board to write the word of the Lord on it.
Why would the... What time was this?
About 1 hour ago.
Whereabouts?
Up on the strip.
And how many were there?
4.
Mm-hmm.
How long you in this place?
A couple of years.
Yeah? You do all right?
Well, turnover's great. I mean, it's one of 3 clubs in the cross that's got a 6 a.m. licence. But drugs are a problem. Half the staff's got their hands in the till. Every time Dick and Harry thinks they got the right to hit on you for a freebie.
Quick licensing check, Mel. I trust no one's underage.
I'm not drinking, mate, so...
You know, I file a report, you could lose your liquor licence. Or you could just pay an on-the-spot fine.
He had you going, didn't he? Gun trap, we got some work to do. See you, boys.
Yeah, see you later.
Is there a problem? You're a bit warm in there, mate. I mean, opportunity knocks and everything, but don't you think you're kind of brazen?
I thought you'd be pleased. Buy yourself a few more flash pavers, eh?
Let's see if we can hunt down poor old Bible boy's word of God. Hey, matey. What'd he look like?
There were four.
You're too pissed to drive Freeman home.
What can I have done? What's wrong with you, man? I've been driving since before you knew how to fucking drive.
Hey, you're not considering driving, are you, Hammer?
What?
How many beers have you had?
I haven't had any beers.
Well, find that hard to believe.
I'm sweet as.
Why, sweetie?
Step back, please, sir.
Come home fast some more.
I want you to go home by yourself. Say hello to your mother for me.
Oh, really, huh? Cheeky, huh?
Right, I think you guys need to take a break. Why don't you go have a coffee, huh?
Why don't you just fuck off?
Do you want to spend the rest of the night in the locker?
You fucking cops are fucking dogs,
Step back, sir. Now, you get behind the wheel of a car, I will bang you up so fast you'll need a checkered flag.
Hey, no one's driving here, officers. These lovely boys were just going up to play a game of Manila, weren't you? Bet Billy Bay's got a pocket full of cash and he's itching to lose. Go clean him out for me, eh? Go on. I'll take care of the other. Go on. Sorry, officers. Smile, mate. Smile.
See you, sweetie.
Dogs, mate.
Sorry, officers. The boys had a busy night, so they sent me.
You got a fucking license?
Yeah, of course.
That new place, what's the ask?
800.
Right, well, after compliance, we'd have to be getting not less than 15% over 3 years. Get yourself a taxi at the end of the road.
Hey, Mr. Freeman. Compliance means conforming, right? Like conforming to government regulations, safety and shit. Hey, what do you and Mr. McPherson look for in a club? Is it just a street or does the building matter too?
Didn't realise you taught basic business to the hired muscle.
Hey, I want to be like you guys, Mr. Freeman. Mr. McPherson, I want to be as successful as you, you know? Like, I want to have what you've got.
Sure you do.
Hey, I don't want to be someone else's bat all my life. No offense.
Cocky little shit, aren't you?
You still at school?
I can read, write, multiply. Nothing more school could teach me.
In other words, they kicked you out. I was expelled from 3 schools. I left for good when I was 14. Told the Chinese to stay put.
They got a whole fucking town named after them. We get the cross.
Well, you don't trust Asians?
Chinks, wogs, labos, bog Irish, poms, Aussies, doesn't bother me.
Me and Lenny, we got the casino urns east of Elizabeth Street.
Hey, Georgie.
Hey, g'day, Georgie.
Hey, Lenny.
G'day, Dal.
Sweetheart, this is John.
Hi.
Hi.
Sweetie, the estate agent called. We can check out that place in the Highlands this weekend.
Looking forward to it, sweetheart.
Hey, not too many of those. Cholesterol is a silent killer. Nice to meet you, John.
Nice to meet you.
Nice to the front, sweetheart.
Like King Arthur with Merlin, John Abraham sat at George Freeman's well-shod feet and soaked up everything the colourful racing identity had to teach. Two of his most important lessons were about money and respect.
You can't take something for nothing. You pay your people, you pay them well. You pay your suppliers. Fuck me. Even pay some taxes. If you're serious about making money, then you've got to stay out of trouble. And you won't stay out of trouble if you don't give people what they've earned. And that includes respect. Especially respect. Do your time, son. 3 or 4 years in kindy and who knows. One day you might even know one end of the cross from the other.
Four years, eh? We'll wait and see.
You're fucking kidding me. You went inside Freeman's house.
Swear to God.
He invited me in.
Hand me a cup of tea. You should see Freeman's missus. She is hot.
What, mate? You still think I can't handle myself?
No, I think you're a fucking little crawler.
All right. I gotta go anyway.
Where you going, bro?
School social.
School social?
Yeah.
Isn't he expelled?
In fact, he'd been expelled and explicitly forbidden from attending any school functions. But that wasn't John's biggest problem. The social was fancy dress, and like Cinderella, he had nothing to wear.
Oi, mate. How much for your suit?
What?
The bear suit. I need it.
Koalas are not bears. Save the wilderness.
Oi!
You'd steal from the environment?
I don't want your money, I need your suit. Hey, listen, I'm hiring it. Or you can consider it a bloody donation, but I need your suit, right? Give me the suit.
No.
Give me your
no.
suit.
No!
You need your bloody
Fuck
suit.
Fuck off!
Abraham. Everyone, masks off. Masks off, please.
You see the look on his face?
Yeah, it's pretty priceless. Hey, did you know that koalas spend like 18 hours of the day sleeping?
Really?
Yeah.
What do they do with the rest of the time?
They watch TV and play video games. No, I'm serious.
You are not like anybody else, you know that.
That suits me just fine.
Cheers, mate. Save my ass.
Lenny, Hammer, they'd all drummed it into John's skull that order on the streets was vital. Maybe that's why he decided to jump into a fight that didn't concern him, between guys he didn't even know. It's probably faster than calling an ambulance, which is important when your liver's sliced in half, your intestines are chopped spaghetti, and you've got a collapsed lung.
The boys.
Everyone's at the most prone to Allah for not sending you to paradise. Get some rest, man. Relax.
One of our boys. You didn't know that.
Don't know if I can do this, George.
Let's just wait and see, shall we? You're gonna be okay, John. You'll get better. But you're too pretty and too small to be the toughest.
That's what I always say.
But you're smart enough to be the smartest. Look, I gotta get out before this nut smoking kills me.
Arrived in King's Cross, following her heart. Or to be more accurate, following her Prince Charming, because he told her the Golden Mile was the only place to be, the happening place. He was right.
I'd mention the
you're
fucking foyer.
Prostitute.
No, look, Kim, this is your fault. It is. I got needs, okay? I have sophisticated needs, and I have every right to have them fulfilled.
Well, it's just
it's fair.
That you sell it. Not for us in a fancy
Kim, I wouldn't do any of this with the other women if you were such a bloody rude.
You should be ashamed of yourself.
Yeah, you got a sweet girl and you say shit like that to her.
Sorry, no one asked either of you. Just, please.
You never said anything to me.
Oh, it's never their fault. Always the ladies.
Silly knob.
Oh, sorry, is this a fucking feminist convention or something? Is that what's... You know, you spoil everything, Kimberly.
Right, that's it. Come with us. We'll get you a coffee.
Well, hang on. Oi, hang on. What about my blowjob?
Blow it out your ass.
Blow it out your ass. That's charming, that is. You are a plank of wood in bed, Kim, you starfish bitch!
Who's gonna marry him?
You don't want to marry that dick, do you?
Actually, yeah. He was my first.
He was your first.
Jeez, honey. If I married the first bloke who fucked me, I'd be married to my uncle.
So what do you do, Kim?
I work in a cafe.
Get tips?
Not really. Thank you.
You don't mind me asking, how much do you make a week?
About 160.
And you don't drink?
Do you earn good money?
Slow week, maybe a grand. If we're busy or I do specials, I can make two.
$2,000 in a week?
Ever thought of this line of work, Kim?
What? No. I mean, I'm happy doing what I'm doing.
Of course, Kim didn't really believe that, nor did anyone else. But she wasn't ready to admit it. Not just yet. George Freeman provided a home collection service for punters who'd somehow forgotten to settle up their gambling debts.
You've got 20 seconds to come up with George Freeman, 20 grand.
They're already fucking...
Hey, what are you fucking doing here?
Collecting for Frank Moon.
Frank Moon?
I swear I was going to pay Mr. Freeman.
Shut up!
Don't move. You guys all right away so I can make a call?
Set a limit, huh? You don't have the money? Don't play, you understand?
Yeah, George.
I mean, how many times do I have to come here?
Yeah, John,
how many times?
Got a bit of a problem here, mate.
You understand what I'm saying?
Yeah, huh? Frank Moon's boys are here.
You want me to hurt
you? Seems he had gambling debts to him too.
So? Yeah.
You're not fucking trying hard enough.
Well, I was just wondering what you'd like us to do, that's all.
Right?
And what the fuck do you think I want you to do? Excuse my French, sweetheart.
He's sending Lenny McPherson over to sort it out.
What?
But we're supposed to hold you down till we get to
you. No, man!
Metamos, give it to them!
Take it. 200's mine, huh?
I hope you're telling the truth, buddy.
He is, Johnny.
Yeah?
He is.
Okay. Don't spend it all at once, eh?
You need some juice?
Catch up with you later, eh?
Doing what?
Yeah, teaching.
You're after some more door shifts. You know we can give you as many as you want.
I want to make you an offer, actually.
One I can refuse, or you got someone waiting for me up the alley?
I want to buy a share of this place, Mel.
You what?
I want to buy into the tunnel. Go into partnerships with you and the other owners.
Son, a nightclub is not a kebab shop.
I don't want to own a kebab shop.
You're serious? You really want to buy in?
Of course I'm serious. Mel, this club is a place to be seen.
Is it just you we'll be cozying up with, or... is this really an offer from the company?
It's just me, mate.
So George and Lenny don't know what you're up to?
You think about this. You have me on board, you won't be paying $500 protection every week.
No, don't worry, I can see the advantages.
Right? Plus, I still work the doors, watch the other staff, and get rid of all the dead weights, mate.
Son, it sounds beautiful.
So how much? How much for 20%?
Son, the tunnel's worth 1.5 mil.
Do me cheaper for cash.
I'll see you soon.
Saw an opportunity, grabbed it with both hands, and never looked back. That was the secret to success on the Golden Mile, seizing the moment with both hands.
Johnny, is that you?
Morning, Mrs. Wilson. Just doing your bins.
Up so early, you're a good boy. You tell your mother she's lucky to have such a hard-working boy.
Okay. See ya.
The office for, Scott? About a week, I reckon.
Trevor says you and Chook are going after the bluefin.
Fishy, fishy, fishy.
Right, tried the homebrew? 8%.
Oh, yeah.
You like fishing?
Yeah, except I get bloody seasick. And a fish can make me get a rash all around. It does.
Why do you go then?
I'll give my wife a bit of a break. You know, plus Chook needs someone to boss her around. Don't you, mate? Boss me around?
You bloody need it, mate. You need it.
That little incident with those thugs on Darlow Road might be coming back to haunt you. Oh,
thanks, mate. I thought they pleaded guilty of fray.
Yeah, one of them works in security, loses his license if he gets a conviction, so he's changed to not guilty. Oh. Now, look, while I fully support your version of evidence, this could mean more negative publicity for your blokes up the cross.
Mm-hmm.
I already got Polly screaming about corruption.
Mate, steak or, sausage?
Steak, thanks, mate.
So what are you saying?
All I'm saying is it'd be in your best interest to get a win up your way.
Then our arrest rates in this city are as high as any other station.
Yeah, piddling junkies and two-bit drug dealers. Talk a major bust. One that gets headlines, makes you blokes look like a cross between Serpico and Jesus.
Which we are.
Just do something good and be seen doing it.
Target is Bill Bayer.
Major heroin dealer of these parts.
Well, our information has him mid-range, at best.
Well, everything we're hearing from the coalface says he's ambitious, moving up. Got a big shipment coming in from Asia.
You see, this gives us an opportunity to actually make a dent inside the smack trade, you know, instead of pissing our fine efforts up against the wall.
What's your plan?
Well, we've nabbed one of our Bayer street dealers. Ali Kazawi. Today's got a record as long as a donkey's dick. A donkey's tail, sorry. We explained to him that he could either do 5 or 10 for dealing in prohibited substances, or he could do himself and us a favour. So he's agreed to meet with Bayer and put a request in for a large quantity of heroin to sell to his lab mates back in Parramatta. So what we do is we give Ali the cash, we organise a place for the exchange, and when Bayer hands over the smack, bam, we nab him. For the lot.
So what do you want from the AFP? A gold star?
Inspector Lloyd, the only way a rat-smart drug dealer like Bayer is going to go for a deal like this as if he's offered big numbers. Anything pissy and he'll smell a setup a mile off.
How much is he selling?
2 kilos, 75% pure. Street value, 1.4 million. Wholesale value...
About 200 grand.
So you know what we're up against. Us state coppers can't raise that sort of cash, but you feds can.
$200,000 is a lot of money.
Well, Bayer's a lot of dealer.
I'd have to be across all the planning. Every detail.
Absolutely. Joint operation, including sharing in the glory when we make one of the biggest drug busts in this city.
Cut flowers, it's killing them.
I forgot.
You won't do it again?
I won't do it again.
$15.
Well, you spent it and you forgot about it.
No, I didn't.
I didn't fucking take it.
Well, where is it then?
Oh, come on, you tell me you love me and you give me shit all the time.
Don't know what to do.
He steals from you. He screws other women. He's into drugs. Kim, it doesn't take a brain surgeon. You're not still stuck on the idea that if you sleep with a guy, you've got to marry him, are you?
It's not that weird.
Oh, yes, it is.
Anyway, I need money to move out. I need a bond and a week's rent. That's going to take me bloody weeks to save up.
So get a better job. In high school, you always said you wanted to be a copper. Make your fantasies come true.
What?
Stacy, blonde and buxom. Didn't you say those hookers you met earned like $2,000 a week?
Yeah, for having sex with men they don't know.
So I do that practically every Friday night, and the only thing I get out of it is a couple of lousy tequilas. Come on, my bank bill is off the planet. I know a girl. She worked for an escort agency. It'd be all right, I reckon.
Maybe I am to blame. Trent says I'm frigid.
Maybe well.
You talked to your partners yet?
I told them you're knee-high to a grasshopper. They could see the advantage of going with someone with your youthful enthusiasm and particular skills for $140,000.
With a deposit of what?
$70,000.
Now, George, can you hold this for me? Actually, you know what? Can you hold all my pay from now on? You know, be my bank.
You'll be asking for interest next.
You saving for something special, John?
You know, I just see these other pricks. Money goes through their hands like water. Haven't got money in your pocket, you can't spend it, can you? Thanks, George.
Ambitious copper Dennis Kelly was another man who understood the importance of seizing the day. He knew a golden opportunity when he saw one.
You watch it, Davo.
And Dennis never looked a gift horse in the mouth.
Excuse me, Inspector.
Mr. Wu, another fantastic spread, thank you.
Thank you, yes. Apologies for intruding, but my wife's nephew, you recall he got into some trouble.
Armed robbery, got 6 years?
Yes, it's a foolish boy who deserved his sentence.
He should be due for release soon.
And we fear he will be deported. He intended applying for permanent residency, but this incident...
How is the boy doing these days?
Ashamed of his past. Reformed.
And if he were to stay?
I would give him a job. The family would be very, very strict. He just needs this chance. We would be most, most grateful.
He said, hey, what's your name? She said, touch me. He said, girl, what's your name? She said, touch me. I'll show you everything there is to show. I'll teach you things you don't even know. We're going down to the river, then we're gonna go deeper.
Point is here. Unmarked units here, here, here. Marked units for backup should remain in constant radio contact but out of sight. Now Bayer's likely to arrive in his car, which
Blue
is
Merc.
Thank you. And Mr. Ghazawi will approach down Waratah Street on foot.
No one goes in until the exchange has happened, okay? We want to get him for the lot. Someone goes off half-cocked. Someone goes in before he's actually handed over the smack and taken the money, then we lose half our charge sheet. And no one gets any thanks of a grateful nation. Any questions?
Okay. Let's make it a good one. Not a Mercedes.
Yeah, that's Bayer.
I can't see the driver. Just hand it over. Shit.
All units, go, go, go! Tom, go!
What the fuck happened?
It's a late model Ford. Commodore, possibly. Shit! Registration number. There is no plates. Okay, approach. Transport, yeah!
sure it's Bayer in the car?
Car travelling south of the service lane. All units converge at the southern end.
Ghazawi was found 2 hours later in a back lane in Marrickville.
I'm looking into the window and it wasn't Bill. It was two other clams I've never seen before. One of them's all, Bill sent me. And I'm all, where's the smack? And he's all, get in a fucking car and I'll take you to it. And I'm all, no fucking way am I getting your car. And he's all, get in the car, dickhead. And then he fucking pulls a gun on me. And I'm all, don't fucking shoot me, okay? And he's all, I won't shoot you if you get in a fucking car.
What happened to the money?
I don't fucking know. Blacked out when they gave me this.
What happened to the money? Good question. $200,000 had to go around a fair few people. But as they said back then, everyone got a drink out of it. Everyone in on the joke, that is. There was talk, of course, and plenty of people suspected a scam. But knowing corruption exists is one thing. Proving it, well, that's something else.
How was the fishing trip?
Trip was good. Look, hey.
Gross.
Hey, Chewy. Happy birthday, mate. Present for you.
Thanks, Trip.
Skulls, one for you too, mate. Buy yourself that new rod, eh?
Trevor.
Enjoy.
Thank you.
South Wales MP John Hatton had run a crusade against police corruption. So far, he'd failed to get the numbers in Parliament for the Royal Commission he wanted, but the media were beginning to get behind him, and a few senior officers could see which way the wind was blowing.
Nose to the grindstone, good to see, mate.
Slumming it, sir.
You're invited to a party Friday night.
What's the occasion?
The dawning of the age of Aquarius.
That party became the stuff of legend. Assistant commissioners, chief supers, supers, chief inspectors, the odd inspector, they put their heads together and drew a line in the sand.
Whether Hatton gets his Royal Commission or not, these are changing times.
Old ways belong to old times.
Exactly. Rule a line, turn the page. It's the only way forward.
Mate.
Thank you very much, Dennis. Cheers. So, do you have to read to get one of those?
That's Chuck Matt in the ring. God lucky.
Good on you, mate.
Congratulations.
You didn't take my advice.
Mate, I hang off your every fucking word. You know that.
Yeah, I don't remember advising you to rip off the feds. 200 grand.
Oh, God. Come on, Dan. No one got hurt, did they? Through to the keeper?
The word is from above. We've got to keep our noses clean.
And, you know, those fucking desk jockeys and their fucking gab fest. There's nothing in it.
It's not how I saw it, mate. I saw it as a warning. You were at that meeting. Well, well, well. Moving up in the world, aren't we, Matty?
Playing with the big fellas.
Well, good on you, mate.
Betting.
You. You're not hungry, Piggy, huh? Why?
Probably still full from last night.
Why?
Had a mountain of fish, didn't you, Piglet?
I might take it for a checkup.
What do you want?
Just the yellow pages. Thank you.
Morning, Mrs. Freeman. Is George there?
Thanks.
George. Yeah, just wondering if we can organise my payday.
So, what made you choose us?
Your ad was probably the classiest.
It pays to spend that little bit extra, doesn't it? Now, have you done any escort work before?
No. But we're up for it.
Lovely. Our girls are all so happy. No complaints. And the nicest clients. Now, are you aware that escorting involves nudity? You have to take your clothes off. And it can involve sex.
What's the pay like?
$250 for 2 hours. Clients call us. We paid you. You phone us for the address. We take $100 in fees, and you lovely ladies get to keep the rest.
Directed to the man and me.
Tunnel. I won't be paying anymore.
What makes them so special?
Well, I bought the place.
You what?
Bought into the tunnel, 20%. I figure I don't need to pay myself to protect the place.
You got some balls, son.
Sure about Shifty, but he was definitely cheeky. In fact, he was still too young to buy a beer in his own nightclub.
You're not going to bail out, are you? I'm only doing this a couple of times, though. I mean, I've got a bond amount. Yeah. Me too. In Coogee. Last one to make a grand's rotten root. Bye!
Job, then maybe you can play with yourself. What are you doing?
Isn't that right?
Haven't you done this before?
Shit.
You know, you might be a bit too straight for this sort of work.
Destiny, empowered herself, but part of her brain was screaming. Had she just sold her soul for the price of the rent?
Next Sunday on Underbelly.
Jesus, Kim, what has gotten into you?
Where are you? Can I come and see you?
Doesn't make you scared.
You think I'd buy a club in the Cross if anything scared me?
I've got runners all over the streets. There's a battle on about who they work for. Can't any of you kids bring this shit out of control?
What are you doing?
Drugs is money, money's power. It's not what you want. How else are you going to get the big king shit?
Only take someone on when you know the odds are in your favour. It doesn't matter what the battle is.
What they can and can't do. You get your heads together and you do something.
Underbelly, the Golden Mile, next Sunday, 8:30.
The Underbelly Experience continues online now. Meet the Fizz. He'll give you exclusive Underbelly inside information. Go to 9msn.com.au/underbelly.